Starting with K3S release version 1.21.0, all new installations of K3S include Traefik V2 as the ingress controller. Traefik 2 changes the way ingress records are handled. As a result, some of the instructions in my existing K3S videos may warn or just not work. This video is broken up into sections, one for each of my older K3S tutorials, or at least the ones that require changes. Each section discusses the changes that need to be made in order to use K3S with Traefik 2. In addition, the article versions have been updated on my site, carpie.net, and you can find the updated configuration files on my GitLab account at gitlab.com/carpie. There are also links in the description. In the K3S installation video, there are no actual changes related to Traefik, but there are a couple of things you need to be aware that have changed over time. First, newer versions of Raspberry Pi OS have cgroups disabled by default. We need it for K3S, so when installing Raspberry Pi OS, we need to add cgroup memory equals 1, cgroup enable equals memory, to the end of the line in /boot/commandline.txt before unmounting our SD card. This is needed at 5 minutes and 46 seconds in the video. For deploying the Nginx sample in the need for Traefik section, the command I use in the video no longer works as is. We need to replace deployment with pod to make it work again. In the ingress configuration section, we see our first change for Traefik V2. The recommended way to configure ingress in Traefik 2 is to use Traefik's custom resource definition, or CRD, ingress route. This record is custom to Traefik and allows configuration with Traefik syntax instead of a host of annotations on an ingress object like it was in version 1. We replace the old ingress record with a new ingress route that looks like this. For entry points, K3S deploys Traefik with 2, web and web secure, for HTTP and HTTPS protocols respectively. Here we use web for HTTP. We then define a route that matches the root path. Traefik defines two matchers for matching paths, path and path prefix. Path is used to match exact paths, and path prefix is used to match the beginning of a path. Both can take sequences of path definitions and support regular expression matching. Here we keep it simple and just use slash. And finally, we tell the ingress route to route to our MySite Nginx service on port 80 in a slightly different format than we used before. In the creating a second site to deploy section, we obviously need to make the ingress record there an ingress route. Before we do, however, we need to discuss another change. At 10 minutes and 18 seconds in the video, we talk about using an annotation to strip the MyDog prefix off the path before sending it to the service. This is now done with another Traefik CRD middleware, so we need to make a strip prefix middleware and reference it in the ingress route. The whole ingress route configuration looks like this. The ingress route is pretty much the same as MySite, except we're using MyDog with a path prefix to get /MyDog and all of its child paths. Obviously, we're routing to the MyDog Nginx service instead of the MySite one. You'll also notice we call out the middleware MyDog strip prefix, which is defined just below the ingress record with a middleware record. It does what it says and strips MyDog off the path before passing to the service. At 2 minutes and 40 seconds in the cert-manager video, we install cert-manager YAML at a specific version. We can now just reference the latest version with the following URL. The whole curl line now looks like this. Setting up the issuers and certificates is the same, except you'll get a warning for using the API version cert-manager.io version 1 alpha 2 lines, as they are no longer alpha. So instead, you can drop the alpha 2 and just use API version cert-manager.io v1 for both the issuers and the certificates. At 11:32 in the video, when configuring a certificate resource, we entered a common name field. That is no longer needed, so we can omit that and just use the DNS names field. At 8:13 in the video, I state that all we have to do is modify our site YAML file to request a certificate. This is no longer true. With Traefik 2 ingress routes, we need to manually request the certificate once and have it store the cert in a Kubernetes secret like we did when we were testing the Let's Encrypt staging. We only have to do this once for each certificate we need. After that, Cert Manager will keep the certificates up to date automatically. So let's insert the manual certificate creation step. We can add the certificate config into our MySite YAML file as just another section. It'll look like this. You can see it's the same as the certificate request we did earlier, except we've changed the issuer name field to Let's Encrypt-Prod to use the production issuer. At 1855 in the video, we modify the Kubernetes ingress record to use TLS. For Traefik v2, we'll modify the ingress route record instead. The updated record will look like this. The only thing we've done is change the entry point from web to web secure, which is the HTTPS entry point. And we've added the TLS entry with a secret name of k3s-carpie.net-tls, which is the secret we defined in the certificate request. And of course, we can apply this with kubectl apply-f mysite.yaml like normal. At 7:57 in the Docker registry video, we configure the ingress record. For Traefik 2, we need to create a certificate record to request our TLS cert and configure an ingress route to use it. The combined configuration will look like this. At 8:15 in the video, we go back and fix an ingress issue from a previous video. With the ingress route updates, this is no longer an issue, so we can skip this step and skip forward to 10:28 in the video. At 13:05 in the custom Docker images video, we edit the existing mysite.yaml about a path for our new service. We need a couple of changes here. First, we'll add a route to the new ingress route record for our /4 path. Then we'll add a middleware to strip the prefix before passing the Traefik to the service. Here's what that looks like. We add a rule to the route section for the new path. We use path prefix here so that 4 receives all the Traefik that starts with /4/. Finally, we add a middleware, 4-strip prefix that we define in a middleware record. This tells Traefik to strip the leading /4 off the path when passing requests to our service. So in summary, the two biggest changes we had to deal with is switching to the Traefik CRDs for ingress and using middleware to do things that were previously done with the annotations. There are also some new features we haven't looked at yet, like TCP support. We are only routing HTTP Traefik. We may explore this in future videos. One note for existing K3s users, as I understand it, if you install the newer K3s over your existing K3s installation, it will detect Traefik version 1 and keep it, so you wouldn't need to do these changes. In my case, the upgrade worked, but my certificate renewal stopped working, so I ended up reinstalling my cluster. Your mileage, of course, may vary. I hope these updates are useful to you. Let me know in the comments if you find new or better ways to configure things. That's all for this video. Thanks for watching.
If you like this video and would like to see more, please consider subscribing to my channel.